So there it is, seal installed. Now, you may think that those are evenly spaced, and they are not. There's only one way this gasket goes on, and that's not it. And that's close to it. I know I had it this way up. And that is it. Almost, maybe? I think so. Drain, right there. Lube drain to the bottom. Oh, speaking of lube. Of gas. Now, did we get everything correct? Why, it fits. That's such a beautiful thing. Click, 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 click. Okay, shift forks, side cover. Well, I guess I'll put the side cover back on to show you this. The arms for the shift forks, one has an O-ring seal, the other does not, which places this one in the forward position because this has a cutout for a seal, of which it did not have one, but the kit does. So that'll go there right nicely, and that's why I put the cover back on. And I have these O-rings, of which only one will fit. They're pretty thin though. They did not supply an O-ring for that, nor did they supply the seal for inside there. However, and that'll go in too, as soon as I put some lube on it. I'm on this. A hammer and a block of wood. Like it! A wee bit of lube, all cleaned and ready to go. Another wee bit of lube. In through the seal. O-ring. This is actually in good shape and I don't want to change it. However, in fact, these look really thin. We have new. We'll install new. Oh, doesn't look so thin once you get it in the groove. Groovy man. Shift forks. Cleaned and ready to go. Wee bit of lube. They're identical. Doesn't matter which one goes where. However, one side of these has more wear than the other. And there's no difference side to side. The most wear will occur on the first gear and second. So, first gear is on the back side moving forward. So, if we take the least amount of wear and put it on the forward edge, that will give us the best operation on that. And second is to the rear. Third is to the front. So we'll take the side with the least amount of wear and we'll put it to second. So, if we raise these detent levers up, shift forks fall into place in the neutral position. I didn't show that to you. Detents! Neutral position. Spring loaded. Raise detent, drop fork. So, once you go into gear with one of them, this prevents it going into a second gear while the first one is in gear. Remove the excess lube from the mating surfaces. cover's lubed. The synchros are lubed, but I think I'll lube them again. Won't hurt the thing, will it? Yes, give it. Where'd my pin go? Oh, it's on the cover. That ought to be more difficult. So while attempting to hold the gasket in place, line the shift forks up on the synchros. Like that. Drop the side cover on. Line up the hole for the alignment pin in the gasket. And it won't go down. So, what's going on here? That's fully seated. That's fully seated. This is not fully seated. I see. Well then, we'll just have to rectify that. There we go. Fork. Least amount of wear to the rear. Raise the detent. Fork falls into place. Gasket again. Flip. Align forks. Drop into place. Almost. What is giving? Fork? Fork? Oh, I see. Cover drops into position. Align the gasket. Install the bolts. I'm getting excited. I'm about to drive my truck, and I think I like it. Click, 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 click. Speedo. What? 3/8 is too small. 7/16 is too big. You mean to tell me that's metric? Oh, it's a sad day, ladies and gentlemen. My 58 has metric components. Okay, one of the things I have not done is put lube on this rear seal. So, henceforth, I shall do that. Lube on the rear seal. We'll do the same for the tranny, or the tranny, drive shaft. Yes, I went ahead and put the U-joints in off camera because I just got done uploading a U-joint video not too long ago. I did it the very same way. So if you go back and you watch that video, you will have seen it all. Drain plug is yet to go in. That's not a drain plug, that's a fill plug. But I still have to fill it, so I'm not going to put it in yet. This has tranny mount bolts. I've been looking at this thing over and over again, noticing it, but not realizing this truck does not take a transmission mount. So this transmission is not original to the truck. I better make sure that slides in there. Could we have gotten this far to find that we can't even use this transmission in this truck? Could we? No! It's the wrong yoke. No. Crap. All that for nothing. 27 spline count. 16 spline count. Not even the right diameter. Goodbye.